It's day 3.
Day 4.
Day 5.
Day 6.
Day
7.
7. 9. 11.
17.
22.
24.
29.
33.
Day 6.
41.
42.
Four graduates from Loughborough University are hoping to set two world records by rowing 3,000 miles across the Atlantic. Now, one of them broke his neck 6 years ago.
Well, he and his three friends are now taking on the challenge to raise money for the charity Spinal Research.
Captain speaking, we are coming into Tenerife at approximately 18.05, 100 hours, local time.
Hello. We are on the ferry over to La Gomera, and it's really exciting. And we're told that when we get off the ferry, the other end, we're going to see our boat almost immediately. So we're all really excited. Can't wait to get there. The sun's shining. It's all good.
This is home for the next 2.5 weeks. Arrived at the boat. First order of the day, shirts off.
Yes, on this
tanning.
Got a lot of work to do over the next couple of weeks.
So the boat came on this trailer, so it's full of crap, so we're just cleaning it off, as you can see here. Got our trusty poo buckets.
Lovely.
Useful.
Don't look at me, I'm so fat.
Here's a quote from the day from Hugo. Ready, 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 go.
Don't act like you're not impressed.
Hello, Brian.
Hello.
Hugh, just do that. Are you filming Greg? It tastes really nice.
I want to touch your ear.
Ow! Sausages, what are those memories?
We have
sausages,
a fantastic
sausages.
Selection of
Adam,
we have Greg, me, Rosie.
What's going on, Rossi?
We are making our food packs. I'm in charge. Three main meals. We've got a wet meal, two dried meals.
Oh no, breakfast.
Breakfast.
Most important meal of the day.
So we're here. 6 o'clock, just finished all the food. And we have scrutineering tomorrow, so that's all ready. And we
242 packets.
We are rolling.
I don't believe you.
I'm on right now.
So we're about to go in to our 9:30 meeting to sort of find out what we're doing for the next 2 weeks. Wood Valley Holly, big meeting, all of the crews will be there.
Bit of wine tasting, and some little finger foods.
We're just trying some delights of La Gomera. We just had a whistling demonstration, which was amazing.
My thoughts and feelings.
Yeah, open up to me.
What happened? We've been at the boat all day, past scrutineering, but for a few small things that need to get done from Simon, and then we're going to go in the water first thing tomorrow.
Rossi, talk to me.
I'm just packing my sour cream and chive flavoured pretzels.
We're going to get this done, and then we're going to put that, our boat, in there.
Great pleasure naming this boat the Spinal Frontier.
Yay! So what's happening at the moment is we're outfitting
the inside of our cabins. Adam fitted these. Really nice pockets to fit things in.
Here are the boys working hard on the boat.
So I am in the cabin of our boat, just getting settled in on one of our training sessions in La Gomera.
We're out rowing this morning. And this precise piece of equipment here failed there and there. So we're building from scratch some aluminium ones.
Adam has yesterday spent most of the day making these aluminium fixings for our footplate. Looks like he's done a really good job there.
So this is Adam to the tune.
Why do you start with so this?
Foghorn test.
Hello.
Hi viewers. We say that like we have any viewers.
We're just in the cabin at sea for the first time ever. And it feels cool.
Here's Rossi's crotch.
Greg's having a little sleep.
And there's Gregory having a Kit Kat.
Just had my first delightful nap on board. I'm going to have my first wee on board in a minute, which I'm looking forward to. I might stand up out of here and smash it out the back.
Look at this man mountain.
That was so uncomfortable.
How did your wee go, Greg?
Good, but I'm too wide to get through the hole.
We've prepared very well, we feel. We're all really comfortable. We had a great meeting last night between the four of us. The boys' girlfriends are coming out Thursday, and then most of the family are coming out on Friday. And then it's across, a little jog across the pond, up to 2 months at sea.
Here we are, Thursday, the 1st of December. Boat preparations are going well, just finalising all the equipment needed to go on. Nearly there, condiments, foam, dry bags, power anchor, drogues, more condiments, tin pizzas for seasickness, Santa hats, the Devon flagpole and the red ensign are on. We've also got everybody to sign it.
We're just waiting to do our photo out here with all of the crews.
After 24 hour delay, hopefully we'll be off in the morning. Leaving La Gomera here, heading across 3,000 miles to Barbados. The Atlantic Corps will be raising money for Spinal Research. Let's get the show on the road.
Here we are. Can't see it. 5th of November. 5th of December, sorry. We are race day. What's happened, Tommy?
We found a ugly dead fish around our boat.
What are you doing?
Doing a clip of my hair for the last time.
Ooh.
Because if I don't clip of my hair, I'll look like Friar Tuck.
So where's this fish?
Throw it over the board.
Oh dear.
Morning!
Oh, Jamie.
How is it?
Do you know how a penis got on our rudder the other
yeah,
day?
Because I drew it.
Thinking, God, what was there to worry about? But I just can't wait to get going. The parents are just there, in Never Ready.
Hey, everybody.
Hello.
Hey.
Atlantic rowing race. Boom. Let's go.
I'm ready to go. It's the most exciting thing.
I'm so excited, so ready.
This
is the first one out of
service. Good luck, everybody. Have a fantastic trip. We look forward to just staying low on the way and having a drink with you in Barbados.
Good luck, everybody. And we are off.
Woo!
This is it. The start of the Atlantic rowing race. We are off to Barbados.
3,000 miles. How hard can it be?
Has the parents gone? Now bring me that horizon.
Good line. One single hour road.
Of how many?
Around 1,200, 1,300.
Superb. Yeah.
This is Greg's first chocolate eating experience. All over the chest. Now, how did you get it on your shoulder?
I accidentally opened a Kit Kat crumbly chocolate whilst reclined.
Boys on for their second hour.
All good. All good. I think we're ill hasn't sunk in yet that we're actually doing this.
We can see on the GPS here. We are this one here. The boat, the silver boat. We're currently sitting in third place.
Hello.
First night done.
Pretty exhausting.
Pretty exciting. Life jackets on, harnesses, waves smashing over the side of the boat. It was pretty intense. Let's have a look at young Rosebud. Gregory, what happened when you tried to take a poo?
It all went a bit horribly wrong.
Tell us more.
Well, I scooped the water a bit wrong and lost my purchase on said bucket on the first day. Hugo, how did you enjoy me pooing right in front of you?
Yeah, lovely. I thought splendid.
Hugo loved it.
I'm Ron Burgundy. And this is what's happening in your world tonight.
Hugo's just done his first onboard poo. It was fascinating to watch. Greg's already having a bit of bum trouble.
My bum hurts. I just tried to row with a lycra that was far too small.
Only 764 miles until our turning point.
This is video diary entry number one for me, and I'm having the shittiest day ever. I just don't want to be on this boat. I just f***ing hate everyone. Play the music! Time keeps dragging. Only joking! Woo!
And I'd let that lonesome whistle blow my blues away.
So Greg's here, it's day four, and it's a hot day, is it, Greg?
I haven't tried rowing naked yet. I'm just starting slowly.
We saw a ship in the horizon called Lady S. We thought it was a cruise liner, but it's a private yacht. And I've charmed her to coming over, so she's now coming astern of us. Come and say hello.
Sent shivers down my spine, body's aching all the time. Goodbye, everybody.
I've got to go. Gotta leave it all behind. Praise the truth. Bum, bum, mama.
wish I'd never been born at all. Carry on, carry on. There's nothing really matters.
Hey, Huge. Bum, 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 bum. What do you think about all this?
I see a little silhouette of a man.
Caramouche, caramouche, will you do the fandango? Thunderbolts and lightning, very, very frightening me.
We're just into day six. Big old waves breaking over the boat. So putting out the para anchor, big parachute of material to keep us held in the right direction. Yeah, we're gonna batten down and try and get four of us inside, so I'll show you a bit of footage in the middle in a minute, show you what that looks like, but it's gonna be pretty comical, the four of us in here. And here we are. So you got one, two, hey Rossi.
Hi.
Three, hi Greg.
Hi, I feel sick.
And I think four, hi Huge.
Morning of the night after our power anchor experience, it was horrible, frankly, absolutely wrecked. The cabin is drenched and wet and horrible.
Hello.
Oh wow, beard. It's the first time I've seen myself in a week and a half.
I was a poorly boy last night. Not good. Hopefully the worst night of the trip for me.
I'm losing weight dramatically already. The six pack's coming back. Still got some floppy skin. But dramatic weight loss. Can't hold this bloody food down to save my life.
Day nine. Mm-hmm. The weather's getting to everybody. It's just relentless following sea that's big swells. Choppy. And now this morning we've got waves coming from all directions. So that's getting to everyone. And then we just found out that Tom Tom's sank last night, and we've been in the vicinity of their vessel for the last 2 days.
In about 100 miles time, we'll be a quarter of the way to Barbados, which is bloody exciting to say. It's not all doom and gloom.
I think I speak for all of us when I say we've all been a bit down in the dumps and miserable today. There's Hugo. But we are having a bit of a moment. There's been a beautiful sunset and we're all happy again. Woo! Right, let's have a good night shift.
Yeah, buddy.
This is me after the worst night of the row. Last night, everything kind of came to a head. Haven't had a chance to have a wash because the conditions have been harsh the whole way. So we're all bloody filthy, trying as hard as we can to stay clean and hygienic. Bums are all starting to kind of suffer. And last night, I was in a lot of pain in my arse. I'm hot. Show the viewers what's going on down below. Nice, firm buttocks.
As you can tell from my sweaty face, this is a very, very hot cabin. So this is my evidence of my first flying fish in my section of the boat, found just this morning. As you can see at the top here, fish roulette scoreboard means that R and H are equal.
Billy Ocean.
Yeah.
Last night's rowing was really tough. Just mentally, couldn't see a thing. Very dark, lots of waves crashing over us.
Is that a Christmassy taste or what?
We're in pain now, with injuries and reoccurring little niggling aches and pains, and it's quite a big thing to try and get our heads around the fact that it's only going to get worse now. Really miss Eloise, really miss Mum and Dad and Jess, and can't wait to see everyone in Barbados. It is going to be phenomenal, that's for sure.
Panda Watch, day 12. We didn't get our Helly Hansen hats for reasons that are unknown to society, but we will make our own.
There it is. My Helly Hansen hat, sponsored now. It's all sponsored.
It's so budget.
Looks great.
This is superhero take one. Adam's about to use his
night vision goggles. No. I can't help the feeling that there's something dragging on the inside of the boat. So I'm gonna go and have a look. No, nothing there.
Oh, it's just got nothing, man. Oh. I just been waiting to get the
whole
camera.
Yeah. I'm having a really emotional day. Yeah. We've just got some really, really good news that we've raised a lot more money from Cheltenham. And that, with the resale of the boat, we're going to hit our £250,000. This is so hard.
I am absolutely bricking myself.
Just make sure it's a good jump. Look into the camera and say something cool and original.
Go.
It's going to be in the video. It's going to be in the highlight reel.
Cool and original.
One giant leap for mankind.
Yeah. It's lovely to get a bit of exercise.
Decided that the weather was calm enough today to have an hour out, clean the deck, clean the boat, do a load of jobs that needed doing, clean the water bottles, which were disgusting, and the best thing of all was we all got in the water and had a swim and a clean. It was so, so good. The second we touched the water, it just felt like a bolt of electricity, massive recharge.
The dagger board won't come up. It's costing us time. So Ross has just gone under to loop a rope under. We're going to try pulling it up. See how it goes. A nice easy process getting us up. Yeah. It's a boy!
Yeah. Right, Ross.
If you push it back your way, it should lever itself out.
Yeah! That was easy.
Oh, it's f***ing knackering.
Right, let's row.
Let's row. Look at this. How's that for a beautiful yet slow day of rowing?
Woo! Merry Christmas, everyone. Merry Christmas, Hugo.
Merry Christmas. Oh, you're a baby. Having fun. It's the season. Love and understanding.
Merry Christmas, G.
Merry Christmas, everyone.
Say moods are generally quite high. We've got a bloody great big suck of Christmas joy. We're about to crack in. Ladies and gents, it's Father Christmas.
Oh, okay. Merry Christmas, everyone. Ooh, Merry Christmas,
this is halfway and we've had an epic day. An epic day of fishing laughs.
Have a little nibble. You're an animal, son. You're an absolute animal. Smile to the camera.
It's good.
Today on Atlantic MasterChef, Dorado with your chef, Ross Turner. Hi, Ross Turner.
Hello.
What are you gonna do for us today?
Well, it's quite simple. It's a Hawaiian recipe called poke, except we don't have 99% of the ingredients. So I'm going to not add any ginger or chili or soy sauce, but I am going to add a little bit of lemon juice, which should naturally cook this beautiful meat.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is a Dorado.
Huge, go for the trophy shot.
The long way to trophy shot.
I'm a ranger, baby. I've got this fin that comes up. Get them in formation.
Woo! And they've been following us the whole way.
Woo!
That's so cool.
Incredible experience ever.
Look at those pits. Could lose a badger in there.
So Hugo and I have just come off night shift, and it's all starting to come together. We've really found the night shift bloody hard since the beginning of this trip. Falling asleep on the oars, hallucinating, and just general horribleness. And they're starting, finally, to become, dare I say it, enjoyable.
Day, and we are having the most amazing morning because we have hot food for the first time in how many weeks? 3 weeks, probably?
2 weeks.
Two and a half weeks, and we have super noodles.
So, boys, what are we discussing?
We've just been discussing that we've been out here rowing for a month.
This is ridiculous.
It's just a really stupid idea.
Whose idea was this?
The goods. Oh, sitting in a nice comfy chair back home. Even an office chair, I don't care. You just have to sit on a red raw arse.
Finish. And that is us. And look how far we've come. Well, it's over.
Yeah, zoom it. Zoom up. Zoom it right out. It looks immense. That's the Atlantic Ocean. And that's us!
Look at my dead hands. Look, how are your dead hands here?
Tanned and dead.
Day 36, Hugh, how are you feeling?
Good. My back's not very good today. But yeah, good. It's really weird we've been at sea for so long.
36 days.
And my beard is coming on well.
Holy crap, that's so bright.
Yeah. Greg, how are you doing?
So tired.
unbelievably tired. Every night now is the last. So this time next week, we should be snuggled up in bed in Barbados.
It's Wednesday, the 11th of January, and we are 318 miles away from Barbados.
I guess it's like the end of term feeling at school. Everyone's just starting to realise the aches and pains that they've been putting off. My hamstring's really bad and cramping for about a week, and my back's really sore. Hugo's got a sore back. Everyone's hurting, so we're nearly there, but this last bit's a bit longer than everyone expected. Okay, so what are we about to do, Huge?
We are about to put up the Barbadian flag.
It's been 6 weeks. We've seen nothing but blue horizon.
I don't want a big spot for arrival day.
Day 41. Coming into Barbados tomorrow morning, and we get our closest pass by cargo ship, MV Sea Orchid.
We just request just a bit of a boost today for us mentally, that you, if it's possible, and you're willing, that you give us a blast on the old horn, over.
Yeah!
It is our final night on board.
Yes.
Tomorrow's it. Tomorrow's the finish line. Tomorrow we see our family. Where's Adam? Wally.
And just over here, hiding behind the cloud.
There he is!
Hello, mate!
It is sunrise on day 42 of our row across the Atlantic, and we are looking at a very big and very clear Barbados. Adam and Hugs are doing the second to final ship. We're going to do an hour on, hour off for the last 4 hours. What about you, Hugs? How are you feeling?
So excited, it's so
weird. So excited! Woo!
Our parents have arrived. It's a boat with all the dads on. Absolutely amazing to see them after so long. There are all of our dads, all of the male sides of all our families, there at last. And here are the women. On a, might I say, much more elegant and sexy boat than our manky old dads are on.